Welcome to your new home in Canada. This video will explain some of the key things you should do in the first 2 weeks to make your transition to life in Canada easier. When you arrive, the first hours at the airport may be confusing, but the most important thing is to be prepared, even before you get on the plane. If you're not sure what to bring, visit the Government of Canada website. The officials here are from the Canada Border Services Agency, also known as CBSA. Canada's Border Services officers have met thousands of newcomers like you and your families. To ensure your smooth arrival and protect the integrity of Canada's customs, immigration, and agricultural laws. The most important item to have with you is your passport, along with a customs declaration card that you will have filled out on the plane. When you meet the Border Services officers, they will ask you questions about your intentions to stay in Canada and the items you are bringing into the country. The completed declaration card helps to tell them this information. If you have any questions about what you should declare, simply ask the officer and they will help you. The CBSA will also need a list, in English or French, of whatever goods may be shipped to you at a later date. The next group of people you will meet are officers specializing in immigration. Their main concern is you and checking your documents on behalf of Immigration, Refugees, and Citizenship Canada, also known as IRCC. Put this paper copy of the Confirmation of Permanent Residence in your passport because your permanent resident card may take up to 6 weeks to be delivered to your new address here in Canada. In order to access government services, you may need to show this document while awaiting your permanent resident card. Now that you have officially arrived in Canada, it's time to settle into your new home. Across Canada, there are immigrant-serving organizations whose goal is to help you settle into your new community. One of your first steps should be to call or visit one of these organizations in your new city. Just be sure to have your permanent residency documents on hand. Some organizations serve a very wide range of immigrants, while others focus their efforts on people who are from a particular religion or language group, or who come from a specific region of the world. Many of the staff members and counselors in these organizations are immigrants themselves, who are happy to share their own experiences with newcomers. They are especially helpful with refugees and immigrants who are having a hard time adjusting to this new environment. They can provide advice on improving your qualifications and skills, finding work or housing, obtaining official documents and government services, and much more. Since most settlement agencies are supported by the government, most of the basic services and advice they provide are available for little or no cost at all to you. You can find a list of immigrant-serving organizations in your area on the Government of Canada website, in the Immigration section. There are a number of important government documents you need to obtain soon after arriving in Canada. Your social insurance number, your government health insurance card, and your permanent resident card. To be able to work in Canada, benefit from the healthcare system, open a bank account, drive a car, or get your kids into school, it's important that you visit a Service Canada Centre in your area and get a social insurance number, or more commonly called a SIN. The visit won't be very complicated, but to apply for your SIN, you'll need to bring your confirmation of permanent residence or other proof of status in Canada, like a work or study permit and your passport. Next, as a permanent resident, you should apply to your provincial or territorial government as soon as possible for a government health insurance card. If you're not sure if you are eligible to apply, check with them. Once you are eligible, which is usually 3 months after you arrive, this card will allow you to receive healthcare services paid through taxes. You can get an application at a doctor's office, a hospital, or an immigrant-serving organization. You can also download the application form from the website of the government department responsible for health in your province or territory. In most regions of Canada, Each family member receives his or her own card with a personal health identification number. Be sure to carry these cards at all times. They will need to be presented at a hospital or clinic when you or someone in your family needs health services. Once you have found a place to stay, don't forget to tell IRCC your Canadian address. We will use this to mail you your permanent resident card. You can update your address through the Immigration section of the Government of Canada website. The permanent resident card is the official proof of your status in Canada. If you're traveling and want to re-enter Canada, you must show this card. You can also use it as a piece of identification in certain situations, such as applying for other government documents, accessing government services, or opening a bank account. Now that you have applied for your government documents, there are a few other things you should think about. To safeguard your money and manage your finances, you should consider opening a Canadian bank account. A bank can also help you get a credit card or debit card. To open a bank account, you must go to a bank in person and present identification. The documents you present must be originals, not photocopies, and be in good condition. Do some research to choose which bank you would like to use. And once you have picked one, visit the local branch for more information on opening an account. Public transportation is an effective and affordable way to get from place to place. Buses are the most common form of urban transportation in Canada, but some cities also have streetcars or trams, light rail trains or subways. You can usually transfer from one mode of transportation to another easily. Learn how to use your community's public transportation, as it will help you get used to your surroundings. If you plan to use it to get around on a daily basis, you should research transportation options before deciding where to live. You can get more information about public transportation in your city or town by visiting an information kiosk at a main transit station or visiting the website of your local municipal government. Be sure to also get a map of your new city and walk around to get to know your neighborhood and the local services available. For most Canadians, the internet is an important tool of everyday life. When you first arrive in Canada, there are a couple of ways that you can access the internet. Most public libraries in Canada offer free internet access. Or if it's more convenient, you can find free Wi-Fi services, which you can use with your smartphone or laptop at many coffee shops or other establishments. Lastly, you should make sure you are prepared in case of an emergency. The emergency telephone number used across Canada is 911. Be sure that you and your family members memorize this number. If you ever require help from paramedics, the police, or the fire department, call this number. Know that relations with the police in Canada may be different than in your home country. The main job of the police in Canada is to protect and serve their communities. Don't ever be afraid to ask the police for help when you need it. You can expect your first couple of weeks in Canada to be a busy time, with a number of things to accomplish. But with the information you've learned, we hope you're well on your way to start settling into your new home. For more details on the topics covered in this video and much more, visit the Government of Canada website. It's a one-stop shop for information about living in Canada and has a wealth of resources that are tailored to your needs, including our Welcome to Canada guide. Visit the link at the bottom of your screen for more information about the topics covered in this video.